In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install ibaPDA-PLC-Xplorer for the first use, set up an interface to a PLC, and to configure some signals for data recording. All you need for the installation is a standard computer with a network card, as well as a current Windows operating system. We start the installation by opening the setup file. For this tutorial, ibaPDA-PLC-Xplorer can be installed with default settings. Please confirm all dialogs with OK or Next. I will skip the installation process for this tutorial. Now ibaPDA-PLC-Xplorer is ready to start. In case you have clicked the option, you will now also see the version history in your default browser. First of all, we open the I/O manager. Here you can see all interfaces that are released via a license on your dongle. ibaPDA-PLC-Xplorer provides an interface bundle to many well-known types of PLCs. Now we will add an exemplary connection to a Symatic S7 controller. Here we add a new S7 Explorer module and assign a name. Now you can see the general settings for the S7 Explorer module. For this tutorial, we can use the default settings. We now continue on to the connection settings, configure the TCP/IP address, and the rack and slot ID of the control. Using tests, we conduct a connection test and get some diagnostic data from the controller. Now we go to the analog signals and also add the signals that we want to access. Just click the button in the column S7 operand and configure the desired operand. Now we continue on to the digital signals and add the signals we want to access. By clicking OK, we accept the configuration and start the data acquisition. The I/O manager will close automatically. The data acquisition is now active and the configured signals are already recorded. To follow the signals online, they can be selected in the signal tree and dragged in the display area. The various signals may be presented in one trend as well as in different trends. The extensive options to configure the signal display will be part of another tutorial. The signal display can be stopped for a better view as by zooming in a waveform. The data acquisition will still remain active in the background. The data recording into a file is pre-configured but can also be adjusted as desired. To do this, we open the Data Storage Manager. Here we see the predefined data store, the maximum time range of a file, the signals to be recorded, and the storage location of the data files. The extensive configuration options for data storage as well as offline analysis of recorded data are part of other tutorials.